Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, everybody! Hello, friends. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho! Welcome, friends. So, Merry Christmas to you. Well, today's the 17th of December, the actual birthday of Christ. So he was born on the 17th of December in the year dot. So, happy birthday to Jesus Christ today. I was one of his disciples in a former lifetime when he was here. So one of my past lives that I know about. It's lovely. So, today's the real Christmas day, but of course, you know, we've been told it's the 25th, so we celebrate it on that day, and it coincides nicely that we can have a week's holiday and get to the new year as well, so I suspect they'd probably keep it there, even if the evidence comes forward that it is actually his birthday on the 17th, So, Merry Christmas to you. I hope you enjoy your holidays and have a lovely, relaxing and calm time, and I'm going to make a New Year's video as well later on, but I've sold my main video camera at the moment. I'm shooting on my DSLR rather than my little vloggy camera today. Just to test it out really as well. I'm going to be buying a new video camera sometime next year. Better quality one than my last one. And, you know, it shoots 4K if you get the upgrade for it. So hopefully, be shooting 4K one of these days, but not on this channel. Later on, I can see myself opening a new channel and doing much greater teachings than I am at the present time, and more enlightened ones, and greatly working with spirit, my spirit guides, and other spirit too at times. So, I've got one spirit guide who's Su Ling. She's my past life spirit wife. We also got married down here through a medium, so we're married in spirit too. So she's beautiful and very loving, and I love it a bit. So she's been Chinese, that's her name, Su Ling. But her last life, she said four lives, was Japanese. So she's with me every day, by my side, looking after me, caring for me, loving me, and I'm loving her back. So we sort of interact with each other, having a cuddle a couple of times a day and stuff at the moment. But my abilities are really closed down at the moment. So, things are going really great for me. Since the spring, I started eating more and more healthily. I'm eating more and more organic food to get rid of all these chemicals and toxins out of my bloodstream, eating a lot of things that help to remove those toxins out of your bones and body and heavy metals. I'm bought a purified water filter and stuff that holds about 4 litres, and so I'm drinking purified water, which only costs about a penny a litre. It's cleaner than the mineral water when it comes out, so doing lots of healthy things. Started my Reiki back in July, done Reiki 1, now I've done Reiki 2, and I'm a qualified Reiki healer now, practitioner, so I can go out and do healing and get insurance and everything for it. I've been healing since 95. But just didn't have a piece of paper to say I could do it. And the person that's taught me is an old friend over at Worthing, which is about 15 miles from here. So I started a spiritual group back in 95, the end of 95 and early 96. She turned up at it and by coincidence found she was just a few miles away. And she went off and done all her Reiki training because she kept saying to me, my hands are getting hot. I said, you're a natural healer. So, she went off and learnt to be a Reiki Seikim healer. And now she's teaching me. So she's a brilliant teacher. She puts a lot of hard effort and work into it. A lot of these Reiki courses are 2 days and that's it, you're qualified, but hers are over 6 period sessions, and she puts a lot more effort into it than most teachers, so you get a great grounding in it. It's really greatly of interest to me, the Reiki particularly, because it just fits to what I already believe in. So you can get the energy from God, you don't have to get it from the universe, all different things that fits me perfectly as well. So I've done my Reiki 1, I've done my qualification to be a healer Reiki 2. In March, I'm starting my Reiki 3 Master, so that's Reiki Master, so that would be 6 sessions again, to go over there 6 times and do that, be then qualified as a Reiki Master. But last month, because I decided I wanted to also go on and be a Reiki Master teacher, so that I can teach others to do Reiki, Seikim and Reiki, we started last month in November. It's a year's training, basically. So it's ongoing, you know what I mean. We're starting to go over there in the in-between periods when I am not having my classes to teach other classes on a Friday, I go to assist my Reiki teacher to teach the classes that she's taking in Reiki 2, which are behind our class. They were another group, and we're assisting teaching those. So we're reading the meditations and teaching them how to do some things to give us experience to be teachers ourselves. So it's great. Yeah. No, she's a great tutor and teacher. And, you know, if you've got a problem, you can go to her anytime and ask her. So it's really, really been a beneficial thing to me. And it's opened up a new side to my life. It's given me a new thing to concentrate on and really get into, and becoming more and more positive all the time. And since August, the middle of August, I really changed to eating just about all organic fruits and veg mostly, and as much good stuff as I could. So I started actually being a lot more sensible with my diet, because I was 14 and a half stone, which was overweight, because I used to be 11 and a half once upon a time when I was younger. I started eating more sensibly, and then I thought, well, I'm going to start getting fit again. And, you know, the body is the temple of the mind, isn't it? And, you know, we've got to look after it. And I've been neglecting mine since all my troubles started back in late 95. So, yeah, I started to look after my body, more and more healthy things, stop using fluoride toothpaste, use all sort of naturally cleaning products, all quite natural ones to not pollute the environment, like bleach and things like this does. So I've gone to organic shampoo and all the rest of it, and eating a lot healthier things, but also exercising 3 times a week. I started 5 times a week to start off with, to try and get some of the weight off, which I do dancing. I used to love dancing, so it's a great way of getting fit dancing, but it wasn't doing much for my upper body. So I have to do some weights 2 times a week for my upper body. So yeah, working out. I am now from 14 half stone down to 12 stone 4 today. So that's, you know, 32 pounds, I think. I'm not quite sure what it is. But anyway, yeah, it's great. So I've lost a lot of weight. I'm quite slim again now. So the belly's gone. Most of the fat around my body's gone now. And I'll be happy around this weight. You know, 12 stone to 12 stone 4 will be just right for me. So, yeah, obviously I'm going to put a bit on over Christmas. So I have to work a bit harder to work it off. So, but yeah, it's great. You know, and I feel a lot healthier for it. I feel more vibrant. So many other things are happening in my life to make me more confident, come out of myself, because I was always a bit introverted. So coming out of myself again, being more confident, taking the Reiki classes, you know, some of it, assisting in it, is really bringing me out and giving me more confidence to teach others and stuff, rather than just sitting in front of a camera and doing it, you know, one-to-one or whatever it is. So yeah, it's all turning around and going nicely. I'm still taking the break from making regular videos at the moment until the springtime, and that, you know, in the spring, hopefully, when it's summer comes, I'm hoping to be able to go down the park, the local park, which is just 5 minutes walk away, and actually try and get a group together through on the internet of people that want to come and do meditations, that want to come and do Reiki healings, and later on hopefully I'll be able to attune some of them and give them their Reiki Seikin qualifications. Also, you know, do different things down there and film it, you know, to put on YouTube. So it'd be a different sort of thing to usual, which would be nice. So yeah, the Reiki I'm doing is Reiki and Seikin, which is incorporating the two together. They're both separate qualifications, the Reiki and the Seikin, but Reiki is a subtle Japanese form of energy healing, which was what I was doing already, you know, through my healing. And I tune into God for it, and my spirit guide Su Ling passes it to me, my spirit wife, and or others sometimes maybe. So yeah, and you know, that's been developed by Dr. Usui out in Japan back in 1921. He based that on the fact that he found out that Christ was a great healer and had done quite wonders through it. So he wanted to rediscover what Christ's talent was at, to, you know, being able to heal. So he went out and he sat on a mountain for 21 days, and a great light descended upon him, which frightened him a bit to begin with. And he was enlightened to what healing was, and he went out and taught it. So Reiki's very popular in the West. It was brought over here by Madame Takata from Hawaii, because she went to Japan because she had cancer and they cured her with it. So So she became a Reiki master and brought it to the West, to America and such like. And Sekhim is Egyptian. You know, it's a, comes from Egyptian. And a guy went, I forget his name now, but he went and he got locked in one of the pyramids at night, and he went and laid in one of the sarcophaguses. And a great purple flame and blue light and stuff come. I don't know if it was blue light, but a great atmospheric thing happened to him, a spiritual thing, where he would become enlightened to the violet flame and different things like this in Sekhim, the lost Egyptian art of energy healing and stuff like this. And he went out and taught it. So some have incorporated it together, you know, the two, which, you know, the Reiki's of more interest to me personally, but yeah, it's great. So it's all great stuff. So I'm really enjoying it. Anyway, I wish you a very Merry Christmas and a, you know, Happy New Year. You know, try and relax. Don't get stressed. Have a good time and enjoy yourselves. Love and light, Neil. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas.